To the Philippine Benchmark Index now, the PSEI closed today's trade at 74.24 after shedding 1.5%. The value turnover was at 5.3 billion pesos. Ariel Santos of Regina Capital Development Corporation now joins us for a chat on the market and more. Hi, Ariel.
Hi, Stan. Thanks for having me again.
It's good to have you on the program now. The 7,500 level is broken officially today. How deep do you think this correction will be?
Well, I think that this is just a technical pullback as the index flirts around the overbought region in the past few days. That said, I think that the deepest correction that the index could face near term would be around 7,350 to 7,300. Mm-hmm. But then a break below that level could take us back to 7,100. But primarily that would be pretty much heavily dependent on macroeconomic factors, particularly inflation and monetary policy, as well as global sentiment driven by geopolitical concerns.
Okay, Ariel, tell us about the Actives Board today. What did investors buy or even sell?
So based on today's market action, investors seem to be picking up badly beaten names yesterday. That's like Ali and Jollibee. Probably they are trying to take advantage of the fact that these names could be an ideal for a quick trade. So, but if we're going to look at on a per-sector basis, I think property and industrial sectors did well today, managing only to log like less than 1% of decline. That's better than the index performance, which it settled at 7.24, and that's reflecting a decline of over 1.5%.
Okay, nothing unusual on the equities. And what about currency now? Peso is weakening now in the 57, or at least courting that level, due to the Middle East conflict. At least that's how a lot of analysts interpret it. Now, what is your outlook for the currency now and in the next 3 months when, you know, you're supposed to be getting more remittances that should, you know, manage the peso slump or the slide in the next 3 months at least, ending the year?
I think the peso's recent depreciation is highly reflective of the heightened risk aversion of investors due to the Middle East conflict. Yeah. So I think that the peso could face further weakness as oil prices spike. And, of course, increasing inflationary pressures are still lingering. So if geopolitical tensions persist, we could see the PHP to move probably toward north of 58. That even though remittance inflows could provide some short-term support in fourth quarter.
Okay, let's talk about China economy now. There seems to be this speed bump on its recovery as stimulus failed to raise sentiment of investors. How do you think that would affect the ASEAN economy in general?
Well, I think that it suggests possible structural issues and which could still drag the growth of the region. So weak demand and deflationary risk persist, which could have a ripple effect not only on the exports and businesses of the local firms that we have that are very much exposed to the Chinese market.
Okay, Ariel, you have something to look forward to next week, at least a further BSP rate cut. Expectations are set at 25 basis points. Now, what do you think? Will this do to the market? Are today's prices already reflecting that, or do you expect some more inspiration can result from those cuts?
This move could still provide a short-term boost to sentiment, particularly for interest rate sensitive sectors like the property and the banking sector. However, I think that the easing of the interest rate has been priced in already. But the market may still react more positively if the BSP signals further cuts or a potential shift toward more aggressive easing. But inflation risk and the peso's weakening could limit the upside.
Okay, Ariel, those looking at the market with a long-term view, those that are zoomed out really, are seeing the market as still flattish. And some views say that long-term growth of this stock market which is generally flat. It is wiser now to really lock in gains, near-term gains at least, versus having a long position. Do you share that view?
Well, I think that it would depend. Locking in near-term gains would be considered as something as a prudent action, especially for those with lower risk tolerance, given the macroeconomic uncertainties and relatively stagnant market conditions. But then for long-term investors, there are some select sectors that possess strong fundamentals, such as financials, holdings, power, consumer staples, which could provide sustained growth opportunities, which could cause them to go long-term in the market.
Okay, here's another thing, Ariel, something to look forward to. Also this month, outlook, third quarter earnings will begin trickling in. What is your view? What's your perspective in terms of corporate earnings for this quarter and in the past 9 months?
For the upcoming earnings releases for 3Q, I think that the results would remain to be mixed. Some sectors like banking and potentially power sector could deliver robust results as, you know, demand remains resilient. On the other hand, consumer-facing sectors could see some potential margin compression due to inflationary pressures there. And while exports could underperform due to weak global demand, particularly if they are reliant on their businesses in China.
All right. Lastly, we end this talk with your trading guidance for the next couple of weeks. What would it be?
For the next couple of weeks or for the upcoming week, I think that traders could take this opportunity or take the recent market action as an opportunity to position, primarily because I think that the index would be able to sustain its uptrend if we're going to look at it. 50-day and even 100-day moving averages. And the technical indicators are pointing that, yes, although that there is a slight bearishness in the market sentiment, however, I think that it wouldn't linger for too long. So for traders, you might consider entering the market at around, at this level, actually.
Okay.
And probably they would likely be continue to play it around the 7.5 level in the coming days. So we can expect as well that the index could consolidate in the next few days, in the upcoming days, with the range, with its lower bound situated at 7.350 and its resistance at 7.500.
So 7.350 is at least a good level to buy. Again, we'll see how that pans out. Ariel Santos, again, thank you so much for this conversation. Good afternoon.
Thank you.